Did you vote to get here today? It kind of feels that way, doesn't it? We should be having a scripture about parting the seas or something. Well, this morning I'm going to see if you can guess what I'm going to have for lunch today, okay? All right, first, this is what I have. What do I got? What is it?
Bread.
Bread, two pieces of bread. What do you think it might be that I'm going to make for lunch? You think a sandwich? Okay, let's see what my second ingredient is. Okay, my second ingredient is this. What's this?
Butter.
Butter, right, okay. So what do you think I'm going to have for lunch?
Toast.
Toast, maybe toast, good idea. All right, should I put the butter on the inside between the two pieces of bread or on the outside? What do you think?
Inside,
you think? Okay. Oh, wait, I forgot I have another ingredient. Maybe this will help. Okay. I have a third ingredient. What do you think? Or maybe a cheese and butter sandwich? What do you think? So what do you think that is in my bag still then, if that's what you're guessing? What do you think's in my bag? Correct. I'm going to make a grilled cheese sandwich. I'm going to make a grilled cheese sandwich. You are right. It's one of my favorites. So when you have ingredients and you put them together, what is that called when you're going to make something? What do you call that? What do you call it here? Cooking. And what do you need to cook with? What's on like the card that you're reading? Either from, ingredients. And if you put all those ingredients together, it's called a what? A recipe, that's right. And today our scripture is a recipe that Jesus gave to the disciples. Because Jesus, now if you remember from last week, he came and he showed up into the room where the disciples were and they were afraid and they weren't sure if it was him. Well, now he has shown up again. Still not sure if he's alive, he's dead, he's a ghost. They're a little not sure about everything. So what Jesus does is he shows them first the scars on his hands and he shows them his feet. And then he sits down at the table and he asks for lunch. Not a grilled cheese, but he asks for some fish. So he's trying to show them that it really is him that is here. He's not a ghost. That was the first ingredient. Then the second ingredient was he reminds them of that everything that has happened up till now is something that was already written in the scriptures. And what was happening that day was already written in the scriptures. So that was ingredient two. Then ingredient three, he said to them, you need to turn all this worry and all this scariness and turn that over to God. You need to look to God and say, what am I going to do next? That was ingredient three. That's a pretty big ingredient. So now Jesus said, so now we've looked at all our ingredients, and what have we made? We have made a recipe for what you can do and go out and bring other people to God. Because you know that I really have gone and I will return. You know that you need to turn your life over to God. And you know to not be afraid because you have that message inside of you. So that is the recipe they went. And guess what? It worked. They went out to tell others all about Jesus and all about God's love. And guess what? 2,000 years later, that recipe still works. Sometimes we make a recipe from a cookbook or from online and it doesn't taste so good. But this recipe always is good. And 2,000 years later, if we know and love God, come to church and learn that Jesus is the one that knows and the one we love and relearn the stories. If we put those ingredients all together, it will work over and over and over. Let us pray. Dear God, you have given us the ingredients we need. Number one, your love. Number two, the stories that we have in the Bible to retell. And three, the ability to go out and share them. Help us to put this recipe together over and over again and share it. Amen.